Hey everybody, Prepper Nurse Juan here. Today is Saturday, June 23rd, 2018. I'm going to kick this around a little bit so you can see the sky. The sun has been kind of in and out. We've had a lot of clouds. We had rain earlier. The forecast was for definite rain today. We had some rain this morning and then it stopped. And so right now we haven't had any in a little while. But just a weird, bizarre weather kind of day. But not uncomfortable, but that's okay. Anyway, I want to jump into the video right away, the topic of the video, okay? And I'm going to ask you what your opinions are, what you guys think. And I definitely want to hear from my buddy over in Sweden on this topic, okay? Sweden is preparing for war. What does Sweden know that we don't know? Why is Sweden preparing for war? I mean, like I said, what information does the Swedish government have that we don't know about? There's nobody preparing for war in the United States, you know, that I know of. They haven't warned the citizens, as Sweden has done, and told their citizens to prepare. You know, that's, I find that quite interesting. I mean, I know that they had called up the reserves and they had done some drills, because my one buddy over there in Sweden, he was talking about that on his channel. And, you know, and he had actually sent me a message saying that they had been called up. So, you know, I find it very, very interesting and disturbing at the same time that you have, you know, a country that is basically telling their citizens to arm, telling their citizens to prepare, be ready for war, have supplies on hand, you know. And over here in the United States, it's just business as usual. We'll just do whatever we normally do. So that is very, very interesting. I mean, if somebody has more information on this, I think we need to share it, you know, down in the comments and talk about this. But if Sweden is preparing for war, why are not we here in the United States also getting ready? I mean, if there is a conflict, most likely we're going to be involved in it as the United States, you know. I have to laugh all the time. I hear this whole big thing, and it's like the United States and the Soviet Union, or the United States and Russia, now they're Russia again. But, you know, they're the enemy, they're the enemy. Guys, I'm going to tell you what, and I've been saying this for probably 20 years, I don't worry about Russia. I don't worry about Russia at all. I worry about China. That's who we got to be nervous about. That's who we need to be worried about. Sure isn't Russia. You know, when you have a country as big as China, and, you know, they're basically in the South China Sea right now expanding their interest out there. And, you know, we've been the big kids on the block for a long, long time. And we're used to having our way with stuff and stuff like that. But I would never underestimate the Chinese. They're very, very smart people. They're way more disciplined than we are. I can guarantee you that. And they're driven. So that would be the people that I would be more concerned about than anything else. If there was some kind of a conflict, I would definitely be worried about China. So, you know, what information do you guys have? What do you have out there that you've heard through the grapevine or whatever? Or like I said, it's just anybody that's got firsthand knowledge, like my buddy over there in Sweden, that, you know, I've been following him and he's been following me for quite a while. What's going on? What are you hearing over there? What's the chatter, you know? I find it very, very interesting, like I said, that that they would be preparing for war and telling their people, their citizens, to have, you know, a supply of food and water on hand in case something jumps off. But over here, like I said, in the United States, they're not telling us a freaking thing, nothing. So, you know, that's something to be concerned about, something that's definitely disturbing. And but like I said, I definitely want your guys' feedback on this. What do you think? You know, should we be worried here in the United States, realistically? I mean, if some kind of conflict goes off, it definitely will affect things globally. You know, I mean, there's no doubt about that. And, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on, a lot of little things here and there. And I don't think people are paying a lot of attention to a lot of it. But I think it's definitely something that we need to pay attention to. We really, truly do. So, like I said, I definitely want to hear what your guys' thoughts are, what you think about this whole situation. So let's go in here real quick. I want to check with the solar and see what we've brought in like I said, the original forecast was rain all day long. So we got 1-4 on this side, and we have 1-9 on that side for a grand total of 3-3 at the moment. So not horrible input, you know, on an overcast day. So I'm not going to complain about that, to be honest with you. And like I said this morning, it was straight raining, you know, here and stuff like that. So the kids at the local school all graduated today. So officially, starting in September, my daughter will be a senior. And that is amazing. It blows me away, to be honest with you. Now, I know some of you are going to ask about Eddie because they are twins. Eddie has, I've withdrawn him from school. He is all done. The educational system for the autistic kids is deplorable. And that's the kindest way that I can actually say it without really getting upset. He technically would still, now think about this. Now, Heather's a senior. They're the same exact age. Technically, he would have been in the eighth grade again. It's just the system. I mean, we had the tutor come, and Tom was absolutely awesome and worked very, very well with Eddie. I will say that, but, you know, it's basically a waste of time at this point. Computer-wise, Eddie is brilliant, and we're still working through that channel to see what we can do as far as getting him to work as far as from home with his laptop. So we're still going to pursue that revenue, but that has nothing to do with the school. That's a whole different entity that has been presented to us. And I talked about that in a previous video. But so Eddie's done. So Eddie will be home with me full time from now on. And, you know, like I said, he does spend time with his mom, obviously, still. But, you know, he will still, even though he's all done with school, he will be living with me full time. And he'll do weekends with mom, and he may do extended a couple, 2-3 days extra here and there. And but, you know, that's all up to them. You know, if she wants him a little bit more, she can have him a little bit more. If not, then she doesn't have to. But so anyway, okay, so good news also. I'll talk about that in tomorrow's video. We'll talk about that in tomorrow's video. So anyway, so that's what's happening today here at the homestead. You know, nothing major. The weather's basically was dictating how the day was going to be. Time flies by, guys. And I'll tell you what, you know, truly try to enjoy it with your children when they're young. I have been blessed this last several years to have had more time with my kids. And it's meant the world to me. It's made such a difference. And it's important. It's important that you're involved in your kids' lives. And that's just not going to work and paying the bills. You need to be truly involved in their lives. And it's really, really important. It's going to rain now. I'm going to kick this around here real quick again. I want to show you this. Really, really dark through there. It's getting darker here. The clouds or rain clouds are coming in now. So I can definitely see that we're definitely going to be getting rain here shortly. But anyway, like I was saying, as I was distracted by looking at the clouds, you know, being involved in your kid's life, being there for support, being there for guidance, very, very important. I really, truly believe that. I got to say, you know, like I said, I have been very blessed to be able to be here for them. And I also am going to say this, you know, and this is not a bash, just so you know, I actually truly feel bad for their mother that she's missed out. Because she really, truly has. And it was her choice. Absolutely her choice. But she's missed so, so much. And that's sad. It really, truly is. Because the kids are a true blessing. Anybody's kids. Any kids are a blessing. And, you know, they don't ask to be brought into this world. But, you know, we as parents need to be responsible. And hopefully, there's at least one parent that's responsible in the home. That's not always the case. Unfortunately, but you know, and the other thing I'm going to say this real quick, guys, please do not use your children as a tool or as revenge against the ex or to hold those kids out from seeing the other parent, be it the mother or the father. That is a horrible thing to do, and there's going to be a lot of resentment down the road if you do that. You know, kids are going to find out if their mom or dad are not up to snuff because they're going to show their true colors. That's what they do. You know, all you got to do is be there for support. So that's kind of important. I wanted to say that too. But anyway, guys, I am going to jump off of here. because it is definitely going to be raining here shortly. I can see it. I'm looking up at the sky again. Remember, guys, hug and kiss the ones you love. Tell them every single day. Tomorrow is not guaranteed. We never know what's going to happen. And remember, STD, it's one step at a time, one thing at a time, and one day at a time. Whatever you're trying to do, whatever you're trying to accomplish, you can do it. The only one that's going to stop you from getting there, guys, is yourself. Nobody else can do it. They really, truly can't. If you work at things methodically, you're going to get there. I've had a lot of people commenting, talking about how, you know, they're pursuing their dreams of living off-grid now and stuff like that, and that I inspired them. And, you know, I appreciate that, and I want to support you guys for that. And I think that it's awesome that you're following your dreams and that you're doing that, because that's what it's all about. You know, we're all in this together. We truly, truly are. So anyway, guys, listen. Definitely, I want to hear your feedback on the topic. You know, why is Sweden getting ready for war? You know, realistically, it's a good question. So let's talk about that, okay? Tell me what you think. I will talk to you guys all tomorrow. Prepper Nurse One, out for now. There's all the, got a bunch of the cats out.